Hello there, guys. Pirateer 12 here. I've just created my YouTube channel and, well, I've been playing War Thunder for 2 years and, patch 1.77 just released today, and we're gonna be taking a look at Abrams and, see what we can do with this, beautiful machine. Taking a look at some valley armors, see where we can get easily penetrated from, as well as see if we can survive a head-on engagement from the front. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take this first pin. So here we are in advance to the Rhine, and we're gonna take I'm gonna take this beautiful machine for a ride and see what we can do with it. I'm pretty much stocking this tank, so but as I'm saying, it handles very well and has good top speed even stock. So the only thing that I've got in here in this tank, it's parts, I believe. What else?
The enemy controls most of the strategic zones.
Parts, tracks, and the FP. So I don't wanna suffer through that. But anyway, we're not able to get a piece of the capture point, so we're just gonna go around and we're gonna go to the center of the park. And see who we can catch off guard. Oh, there's a tank right there. Let's go ahead and climb this a little bit. And there goes our first victim.
Next target.
Goes our first victim. It's approach with caution because we don't know what could be hiding in the bushes. Good hit. He didn't know. He doesn't know where they shot him from. No, he does, but it's too late. Another thing that's very good with this tank, it's the reload rate. I believe it's 6 seconds, which is insane. So he got taken out. Let's go ahead and move behind this small hill right here. I don't want to push so aggressive because we don't know what the enemy has. So we're playing the Russians and the Germans, so most likely some people might have bought the T-64V, which is a very great tank. And the Leo 2K, but I haven't seen any of those tanks in the kill feed. But there's another tank. Poor Leo, he's probably grinding his way up to get the Leo 2K. He's gonna hang out over here for a little bit longer and wait for our teammates to push. Hopefully they got the left side cover. Another thing that's a great improvement, it's the graphics, the overall graphics, how the new engine makes the environment. But anyway, let's go ahead and push with this Challenger and see if we can get some points over here. Well, apparently there's a flanker on the left
side.
So we're praying friend just marked it for us. When he respawned back, oh, I see him. Can't get a shot. That was a late shot. But anyway, let's mark it for the team. And let's get some juicy points here. And we'll go get him afterwards.
Multiple strategic zones are captured.
There he is. You see that explosion?
Wow.
I love the new improvements in this new engine. There's another one apparently. Can't see him through that smoke. Okay, let's go catch him. Whoa! Where did that come from? I didn't see anyone on the bar, but apparently there he is. One of our friends. I can't believe he didn't see him either.
A little more effort and victory will be ours.
Another zone captured. We have the advantage.
These guys are so aggressive. He bounced. Wow. See? If I would have stayed the way I was, he would have gotten me. But our friends were able to take him out, so let's push with them. And see if we can get any more kills. I was trying to answer that guy's question. He was asking if the aprons was okay, basically. But I was like, man, let him find out by himself when he gets it. There's someone over here. Our friend is shooting at him. Yep, there he is. Why was he not able to kill him in the first place? Way it looks like someone is capturing it, even though we've got some team members over here. There goes one. There's a Leo somewhere. Another thing, I'm curious if the Leo, since it's at 8.3 I believe, How would it handle, or how would it perform against this tank when it gets up tier? Because it'll get up tier most of the time. I would say like 90% of the time you will get up tier on the Leo, and now even more that it got the APF SDS, so it should be a more capable tank. Let's go ahead and find him right quick, go around. I hear him somewhere. I hear engine noise. He is nowhere to be seen. So, just gonna hang on a second. See if he pushes. I hear him somewhere. I hear something. Oh, there he is. Look at this.
I agree.
This is like Tokyo Drift, but with a tank.
Attention to the designated grid square.
Marking for the team, he deployed the smoke, and I guess he's gonna try the tactic.
Attention to the map.
Probably gonna either go around smoke or around the building. Oh, never mind this. One shot at him. This thing's pretty amazing, pretty beast. So if you guys, when you guys get this tank, play it play it slow so you can get the feeling of the tank and know what can do and what cannot do, because you can't, you're not Rambo. I mean, you're gonna get shot in this tank, in any tank, so might as well play it safe and help the teammate out. At this point, the battle's pretty much decided. We have won, and just cleaning up the few enemies that are left. So, but we don't want to spawn camp. That's a big no-no. But see, people do it most of the time. They don't care. Even though we've got the spawn protection, most of the time they go through. Spawn protection is, in my opinion, is pretty much useless. Because either way, you're gonna get flanked. Unless you are in this kind of maps where you can hide behind buildings. But in like Older and marginal lines, definitely not. So there it is, guys. The M1 Abrams. First few battles. This is the first battle where it was an ace, I believe. So came up in the top and first place. And let's see what rewards do we get. Thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. Hope you liked it. And if you did, please drop a comment, like, and subscribe.